History Month is a great time to celebrate the excellence and achievements of so many men, women, and children of the past and present. But it's important to understand that Black history goes beyond the names we normally hear about. Today, we would like to continue a new series to recognize Black excellence in our own church family. Throughout the rest of this year, we will highlight our brothers and sisters who are making a difference in our community and making a difference for Christ. One of our very own members is making history every day, and this is his story. It's a typical early Saturday morning, 5:34 a.m. to be exact. It's dark, it's cold, and Darnell Majors is ready for another day of changing lives from the outside in. Brother Majors is the owner of Major Cuts Barbershop in Cedar Hill, Texas. It's a place where anyone can get a great haircut, some good conversation, and a dose of inspiration.
Hi, my name is Darnell Majors, Brother Majors, and I'm a proud member of the Inspiring Body of Christ Church. I've been a member since April 15th of 93, and I'm the proud owner of Major Cuts Barbershop. I grew up in Oak Cliff, Texas, as we call it. I went to South Oak Cliff High School, better known as School of Christians. I went there and graduated in 92, and after me graduating in 92, I left for school to play football at Navarro College. Yes, football was the main goal at the time, and I got there, and first year I got hurt, then the second year I got cut, so I had to go to plan B. I went to the Sheraton, and I thought that was a career path for me, was becoming a cop. And once I got into just a corner of it, I said, well, man, this is not really what I want to do. But the one consistent that was always there was my ability to cut hair. Back in the day, when I was in the seventh grade, my dad would give me $5. I grew up there to the barber college, and he dropped me off at 8. And yeah, I called him around 2 or 3 and said, well, I said, you've been in the barbershop the whole time? I said, yeah, Mama, I just like the atmosphere. I like hanging out. I like being around the barbers. And that's what kind of stuck with me in the seventh grade. I was in church beforehand, but when I went off to college and stuff like that, I kind of stopped going as much as I was consistently as I was going. And one thing that kind of led me to IBOC when I got here, I was kind of looking around the audience. I was like, man, me and my guys only do this out here in the audience. All other brothers are up singing or up ushering and doing that. That really kind of was different for me. So I've never seen anything like that. And that kind of inspired me to want to come back more and more. And as I did, I ended up becoming a member of the usher board and been here ever since. IBOC's in the people business, and that's what barbering is also. It's also part of being in the people business, and that kind of went hand in hand in me that now here 23 some odd years later of me owning my barbershop, that my example was through the ministry, through the church, that whatever the church did, all I had to do was follow that pattern. Good steward of your money, paying tithes off your business, paying tithes off your personal. All of that helped me, and it assisted me in being consistent this long of being in business. And if it wasn't for my ministry, I knew my business wouldn't be as successful as it is today.
Brother Majors is proud of his business, he's proud of his church, and he's proud of the man he has become. But he's most proud of the three young ladies and one young man who call him Dad.
My girls are, I have three girls. My oldest girl is 27, Corin. She's in Houston, last year of law school. And little girl, Carmen, she's a first year TWU freshman. My baby girl, can't count, 10 years old. That's awesome, man. Never thought that we'd have a lawyer in the family. I was a single dad for a few years, and to see her doing that thing now is All glory goes to God on that, man. All glory to God. Wow.
To many others, you're known as Majors, Brother Majors, Darnell, however, Carmen, Cameron, and I have the privilege of calling you Daddy. Daddy, I love you so much. Literally, we've been doing this thing, you know, since you were 19, from a single parent to now, like, you've supported me through undergrad, and now I'm about to be a lawyer. So thank you so much, Dad. Like, there's no rewards for the person that you are, the person that you've been to me and my sisters. We're super grateful and we love you so much. Like, thank you so much for being an awesome dad. Like, I really appreciate it. And the bar is set really high just because of you.
My dad is like a superhero in plain clothing. He taught me, he fought for me, he held me, he nurtured me. But most importantly, he loved me unconditionally. There are not enough words to just describe how important my father is to me and what a powerful influence he became on me and my sisters and everyone that he's ever met or talked to or helped. And he continues to still be that great influence every day. I love my dad so, so much. I can truly say that my pops is the greatest barber in Cedar Hill.
Some people don't believe in here, but they have it on my dad. No matter where you go in life, you're always my number one man. I love you, Dad. You're the best entrepreneur I know. I hope to be as successful as you one day.
Darnell Majors, pops, a husband, a leader. To me, you mean a lot. You're a leader of many. You set the example. You're a businessman, and you're just an all-around great guy. You do so many things and you grind so hard, and I look up to that a lot. That means a lot to me because you set the standard and you set the bar, even when you don't even have to say anything. You don't say anything, but you lead by example, and you're a really big figure in my life, and you mean a lot to me and my family, whether you know it or not. And you keep me happy because you keep my mother happy, and I appreciate it, and I'm forever grateful for you. Each and every single day.
Cedar Hill came to do an interview with me and they asked the question of what is Black history to you? And it was crazy. I couldn't answer the question. My other Barbara Dre said, hey man, you're Black history. And man, it messed me up, brother, hearing that. I never thought in life that I would even, never looked at myself like that as being Black history, but it's kind of what it is. It was just amazing to hear that. Didn't affect me then like it does now, but I just never knew that. Thank God to be able to be, you know, bless other people, feed into their life, plant a seed for them. That's just huge, man. It really is.
Brother Majors, thank you for being an inspiring symbol of Black excellence. And thank you for representing Christ. The best is yet to come in your life.